Hello Internet, my name is Nrupin and since you took your time to stop by this video, I am assuming you are here to learn about technical analysis. Firstly, this is my personal blog. Here I upload videos for myself. Though I upload videos on investing, this video blog is not all about investing. I may upload other videos which you may or you may not like. Before you decide to subscribe, just keep in mind I have very good reputation of leaving bad taste not only by food I cook but also by words I speak. If you want to subscribe, subscribe at your own risk. For starters, I own commission based paint business. Also, I am affiliated with Amazon and Flipkart. In short, I send customers to buy products from their website and they pay me 2 to 10% commission from their profit. My business model is simple. Provide information for free and then ask people to buy things they already want to buy and get commission on it. Sounds simple, but it isn't and requires back-breaking amount of work and investment of money. So please pardon me if I sound like marketer because I am. I also do intraday trading if load shedding isn't interrupting. Please note that all videos will be interconnected as they are in actual investing seminars. Videos will be short or long depending on topic and we will focus on one topic per video. For this video, we will limit our discussion to why technical analysis works, common misconceptions and most important basic concepts of technical analysis. Don't skip anything in introduction. 90% of people who join seminars by paying 2 to 5 lakhs fail because they end up ignoring introduction and conclusion part, thinking middle part is all that matters. But the fact is the opposite is true. If you get basic concepts and conclusion right, the middle part becomes optional. In technical analysis, you read price charts to make trading or investment decisions. By definition, technical analysis is art of identifying a trend reversal at a relatively early stage and riding on that trend until weight of evidence shows or proves that the trend has finally reversed. The weight of evidence refers to different indicators that we use to analyze stocks. Now, technical analysis started with Japanese rice traders Kosaku Kato. Born in year 1716, he was first to realize that price for which rice is traded is not what it should be, but what traders think it should be. For example, a rice bag which should be traded for 100 will get traded for 50 or 200 because traders want to trade at that price. Price of rice was always what traders thought it should be and not the actual price. Price for which rice is traded was not actual price but emotions of other rice traders. He found patterns in candlesticks which he used as emotional indicator of other rice traders to buy and sell rice at most profitable times. It made him most successful and feared rice trader of his time. Western methods of charting were found by different mathematicians and physicists. Even simplistic look on names of technical terms and indicators can give you that idea. Momentum, oscillators, objective difference, noise, simple moving average, exponential moving average, weighted moving average, linear regression, price differential, integrated value, square of 9, relative strength are few to name for. These are terms from mathematics and physics and they mean the same in technical analysis what they mean in mathematics. As you may have heard it several times, buy stocks with good fundamentals for good profit. Everyone is hearing this since beginning of stock market, but in spite of buying stocks with good fundamentals, people suffered losses. And the reason is very obvious. Balance sheet, profit statement and news all can be manipulated to represent fundamental strength. Therefore, there was a need of method to find relation between price move versus good and bad fundamentals. Different people found different types of relations. They published their studies after 20 or 40 years of research And the technical analysis that we know today is developed by combining those different research studies. All those studies were actually done for time frame of 1 to 4 years. But later it was found that due to some unknown reason, technical studies can also be applied to shorter time frames. Their misconception about technical investing is only for short term developed because people started using it mostly for short term gains. Make no mistake, almost all USA investing competition winners of last 10 years have admitted they don't buy stocks based on fundamental unless technical indicators also support fundamental growth. This also applies to William O'Neill, the youngest to ever buy a seat on Wall Street. All fuss about technical investing doesn't work started because Benjamin Graham was misinformed about technical investing, and he spread that misinformation from his book The Intelligent Investor, which was like Bible for value investors. Also, I have always heard technical analysis is speculation, whereas fundamental analysis is the only way to invest. For those who boast this, please listen carefully definition of investment. An investment operation is one which upon thorough analysis promises safety of principal and an adequate return. Operations not meeting these requirements are speculative. Buzzwords are promises safety of principal and adequate return, which in short means guaranteed results. Guarantee is one of those things which doesn't exist in stock market. Therefore, it is always said invest money that you can afford to lose. Be clear, either it be fundamental or technical investing, they all are based on probabilities, not certainties. So if you are putting your money in stock, you are already speculating. In technical analysis too, no matter how strong the signals are, we always assume there is at least 10% chance of failure. In technical analysis, either it be drawing tool or statistical lines, everything is indicator including price, volume and time. To make sure you get highly accurate signals, you must know how many indicators to use, why they should be used and how they should be used. Use 2 or 10 indicators, it doesn't matter. What matters is that combined strength of signal generated by indicators should fulfill 5 points. First, change in momentum along with weakness and confirmation. Second, beginning of new price cycle. Third, trend confirmation. Fourth, trend confirmation should happen on trend lines, support or resistance. And finally, time frame confirmation is also needed. If you know Western, Japanese or price volume pattern, then that can provide additional strength to your analysis. First, price should show change in momentum. Momentum should change by first showing weakness, then by confirming momentum. Instant change in momentum has most of the time found failing miserably to generate any profitable move. Hence, weakness before confirmation is required. Then you need price cycle indicator, and it should be indicating beginning of new price cycle. Third, you need trend confirmation indicator. You buy only when you are sure trend is in your favor. Understanding of trend lines, support and resistance is needed to make assumptions about stop loss and targets. Finally, time frame confirmation, which in short means if stock is moving up in monthly chart, then sell signals on weekly chart are most likely false signals. Similarly, if stock is in uptrend in weekly chart, sell signals of daily chart might be false. On same path, if stock is bullish on daily chart, sell signals of intraday chart might not be profitable or they could be totally fake. Now let's move to actual chart to see how this is applied. So here's Nifty chart for today. Whenever anyone explains technical analysis, in comment people complain they selected a closed or very specific stock for analysis. Therefore, I am intentionally using Nifty chart since it is analyzed by almost every analyst in India every single day. Note that a technical indicator is as good as time you will spend mastering it. There are indicators which can perform more than one task at a time, but I prefer one indicator, one task approach. Indicator selection and its use is just a matter of your own choice. So as I stated earlier, the first thing that we will add is momentum indicator. Now, though I already said that the indicator is only as good as the time you will spend mastering it, RSI is one of my favorite indicator, and not only my favorite indicator, it is favorite indicator of almost 50% of the technical analysis of the world. And the reason is RSI is highly accurate while detecting even minor weakness, divergences, patterns, absolutely anything. So if I would have to advise you to master any momentum indicator, I will surely advise to go for RSI than any other indicator. Now the very first thing that we have to find is weakness and then confirmation. So here we see the value of Nifty is 8035 here, and here 8049. Now RSI at this point is 81, whereas at higher point it is 79. This is called divergence, and this is the weakness that we are looking for. Step number two is getting the confirmation. Now there are many ways to get confirmation from an RSI. Some people prefer level based approach, means 30, 50 and 70, which is already here. But my preferred approach is using a smoothener. So I will add a smoothener here. So to get smoothener, I will do nothing but just add exponential moving average to RSI. Now first we got weakness, now we got confirmation. Now we will add a price cycle indicator. Now there are many price cycle indicators, and almost all of them are really good. Either you used MACAD or Stochastics, KST. My preferred is Stochastics. I like that indicator and I have spent a lot of time mastering it. So I will use the same indicator. And from Stochastics, I prefer slow Stochastics. Now, as you can see here, first the weakness, second the confirmation, and third beginning of new price cycle. And the new price cycle is bearish in nature. Now we need trend confirmation. My preferred approach to get confirmation is by using two double exponential moving averages. So I will add them. Here we get our confirmation. Means you can take a short position from here. Now since this trend reversal happened here, this point will start acting as resistance. Therefore, the short position created here will also be considered as valid if they are supported by Stochastics, or we can say price cycle indicator, and confirmation. At this place, we will not need any weakness because it is already confirmed here. Now this can also be applied to daily chart. So this is daily chart of Nifty. Now there are three times I predicted fall based on this chart on different Facebook groups. Now I will explain how I did that. First, as usual, I will add RSI. Second, I will add Stochastics. Third, I will use double exponential average. So the one property of moving averages is that once price moves above them, they start acting as support, and once price goes below them, they start acting as resistance. I have predicted three times on Facebook groups when the fall is going to happen. The very first time that I predicted was on this day. As you can see, there is already a weakness confirmation. Our price cycle indicator was already in downward trend. What we only needed was a confirmation. When the crossover took place here, it confirmed there will be a fall. Next time when I predicted fall, it was here. As I told you earlier, that moving averages start acting as resistance when price goes below them. And as you can see here, it totally failed to move above it. Therefore, the next day I predicted there will be a fall and this happened. Finally, the last week, 30-day exponential moving average was acting as resistance for price. And as you can see, price failed to move above that line. Therefore, I predicted that this will be the acting resistance for this week. And as you can see, the very second day price fell down and that's it. Here we can see that there is weakness plus a confirmation from both trend and price cycle indicator and still didn't get any profitable move here. And the reason is time frame confirmation. If you will see at the weekly chart, you will find that it is already in downtrend. So most practically, the signals that will be generated on daily chart might not become that profitable, or they might completely turn into false buy signals. To be sure that you should make a better buying decision, the very first thing you need is this chart turning into positive. Unless this turns bullish, majority of buy signals that you will get here on daily chart will be fake. Before we close this video, just few more pointers. As a kid, I loved Batman. While training Robin, Batman tells Robin 5 things about learning that applies to absolutely every learning experience. Learning takes place in 5 stages. First, by reading, you just know. Second, when you see, you understand. Third, when you practice, you master. Fourth, when you experience, you adapt. And fifth, big victories are taken by taking small victories every day. A true master always knows he is master because he spent time not only analyzing his losses but also his victories. Now, to apply concepts of technical investing, you just have to fulfill 5 pointers. In theory, it is really very easy. But think practically, if you are not handicapped, then individually jumping, spinning and kicking are extremely easy activities. But if I ask you to jump and while in air spin and perform a kick, then that wouldn't be that easy. Failure is result of not thinking practically. Matching all 5 pointers while analyzing is not really that easy as it sounds. Practice trading on paper before you get your hands dirty. Practically all charts can be analyzed, but while day trading, prefer stocks with clean looking charts. While day trading, decision has to be taken in matter of seconds. If you will spend time analyzing difficult charts, you might miss profitable trades. Finally, if you prefer online shopping from Amazon or Flipkart and want to support this channel, then please visit Amazon by typing dboxa.com and Flipkart by typing dboxf.com whenever you want to buy anything from those websites. You will land on their respective websites. Depending on products you buy, they will pay me commissions, and be sure you won't be charged extra for anything. My pen business is on startup phase, and your small gesture of gratitude will motivate me create more videos and earn some extra money to support my new business. I intentionally created those URLs the way they are to make sure they should be easy to remember. In next video, we will have a look on trends, supports and resistance. Till then, thanks for watching and have a nice day.